One often useful application of Green's theorem is the ability to find the area of a region R by integrating the area over R, and by integrating the area using Green's theorem so that we're just integrating over the curve that surrounds the area. So, the area of a region R is the integral over R of the area increment. If negative my plus nx is identically equal to 1, if it's always equal to 1, then the area is the integral over the boundary of m dx plus n dy, since this integral has to be equal to the integral of negative my plus nx over the region. So again, if negative my plus nx is 1, then Green's theorem tells us that this integral is equal to this integral. The question then becomes, how can we get negative my plus nx identically equal to 1? The answer is that there are lots of ways. I say let us count the ways. Actually, might be difficult to count the ways since there are infinitely many ways. But there are two ways in particular that are useful. So let's see. How could we get my plus nx identically equal to 1? One way would be let m equal negative y. So my equals negative 1. Negative 1. N equal 0 so that m dx plus n dy is just equal to negative y dx. Then negative my plus nx equals the negative of negative 1 plus 0 equals 1. And the integral of m dx plus n dy becomes the integral of negative y dx, and that has to equal the double integral over the region of negative my plus nx dA, which equals the integral over the region of 1 dA. So, if m equals negative y, it should be clear then, and n equals 0, m equals negative y, n equals 0, then we get negative my plus nx equal 1, and this integral gives us this area. Since n is 0, this integral, this part of the integral goes away. Since m is negative y, we have the integral of negative y dx. Another way is to let m equal 0 and nx equal to 1. Now, nx equal to 1, well, that occurs if n is equal to x. So that m dx plus n dy equals x dy. And without going through all the lines of the argument, the integral of m dx plus n dy is equal to the integral of x dy, which is equal to the integral over the region, again, of 1 dA, which is the area. Now, I've been just a little sloppy here, so let's go ahead and write in C for the curve over which we're integrating. Now, depending on the actual nature of the curve, it might be easier to integrate negative y with respect to x in some cases x with respect to y in others. I said there were infinitely many possibilities for getting negative my plus nx equal to 1. Let me just state, in case you're really interested in this, and this might possibly be useful, that negative my plus nx equals 1, for example, if my is equal to negative ay, and meant to write down m equals negative ay, and n equal to b times x, so that negative my plus nx is negative of negative a plus b, which equals a plus b, equals 1. So that we get the desired characteristic, negative my plus nx equals 1, if my, and I did it again, if m equals negative ay, n equals bx, with the condition that negative a plus b equals 1. And I've written that incorrectly here. I take it back, that was right. So here's the condition. M equals negative ay, n equals bx, a plus b equals 1. If you add my, negative my to nx, you do get 1. And then the integral of the line integral that you get from the m dx plus n dy over whatever your curve is will give you the area inside the curve.